Hello everyone, welcome to my virtual class. This class is for class 10 of West Bengal Board and I am Haruchandra Gaur from Chandan Nagar Sri Aurobindo Vidya Mandir. At first, now we go the description box of this video, and in this description box there is a link, and click the link and download a PDF file, and this file is the assignment of the chapter Tangents to a Circle. Now we try the assignments and time is 30 minutes. So pause the video for 30 minutes. Now the first problem. A triangle is drawn to a circumscribe a circle of radius 4 cm such that the segments BD and DC, into which BC is divided by the point of contact D, are length of 8 cm and 6 cm respectively. See the figure. Now the triangle ABC and the circle is inscribed, and triangle ABC is circumscribed a circle. So definitely the circle is the inscribed in the triangle ABC, and the segments BD and DC, into which BC is divided the point of contact, so D is the point of contact, and length of BD is 8 cm and length of CD is 6 cm respectively. Find the sides AB and AC. At first, we draw the figure. Now, this is the figure. ABC is a triangle. This triangle is circumscribed to a circle whose center is at O. And D is the point of contact. D, E, F, three points are point of contacts, and the point of contact D divide the line segment BC. BD equals to 8 cm and CD equals to 6 cm, and radius of the circle is given. Radius is 4 cm. So this length is 4 cm. So what is the value of AB and AC? Length of AB and length of AC. At first, CD and CF are two tangents through an external point C of a circle. So length of two tangents are equal. So CD equal to 6, so CF equals to 6 cm. Similarly, BD and BF are two tangents passing through external point B, so length of two tangents are equal, so BD equals to 8 cm, so BE equals to 8 cm. Let AF equals to x cm. AF equals to x cm. Now this is x cm. Now AF and AE are two tangents through an external point A, so length of two tangents are equal, so therefore AE equals to also x cm. So therefore length of three sides AB equals to x plus 6 cm. AC equals to x plus 6 cm. AB equals to 8 plus x plus 8 cm, and BC equals to 6 plus 8, so this is equal to 14 cm. So therefore semi-perimeter AC equals to AC plus AB plus BC whole divided by 2. Now this is equals to AX plus 6 plus X plus 8 plus 14 divided by 2. Now this is X plus X 2X 2X by 2, this is X, 6 plus 8, 14, 14 plus 14, 8, 28, 28 by 2, this is X plus 14. So therefore semi-perimeter is X plus 14 centimeter. Now area of triangle ABC using Heron's formula, write the first formula S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C square centimeter, square units. This is the general formula. Now putting the value of semi-perimeter and length of three sides. Now the semi-perimeter S equals to X plus 14 and X plus 14 length of one side minus X minus 6. X plus 14 length of one side minus X minus 8. X plus 14 and length of one side minus 14 square centimeter. Now this is equal to square root X plus 14, X is cancel, 14 minus 6 is 8, X is cancel, 14 minus 8 is 6, and 14 cancel into X square centimeter. This is the now area of the triangle ABC. Also OD, OE and OF are three perpendiculars. The circle is inscribed, so radius is perpendicular to the sides of the triangle. So OD, OE and OF are three perpendiculars. Now join OA. Now we join OA OB, join OA OB, sorry, OC and now this is the area of the triangle ABC. Again area of the triangle, again area of the triangle ABC equals to, again area of triangle ABC is equals to area of the triangle, area of the triangle AOC plus area of the triangle BOC plus area of the triangle AOB. Now area of the triangle AOC, now area of any triangle half into base into height, so half into AC into height is OF plus half area of BOC, half into BC into OD plus half into base is AB into OE. Now this is equals to half into AC. AC is X plus 6 into OF. OF is radius is 4 centimeter tall. Now area is square centimeter plus half BC. BC is 14 and OD is 4 plus half AB is X plus 8 into 4 square centimeter. Now half into 4 common, X plus 6 plus 14 plus X plus 8 square centimeter. This is equals to 4 into, now this is X plus 14, 2X plus 14, 2X plus 28 and 2 half divided. So this is X plus 14 square centimeter. Now this is the area of the triangle ABC and this is now area of the triangle ABC. So by the problem, but therefore these two are equal. So 4 into X plus 14 equals to square root एक्स प्लस 14 इंटू 8, 6 48 एक्स। नाउ स्क्वायरिंग बोथ साइड्स, 4 स्क्वायर इज 16 एंड दिस इज एक्स प्लस 14 होल स्क्वायर, दिस इज इक्वल्स टू एक्स प्लस 14 इंटू 48 एक्स। नाउ एक्स नॉट इक्वल्स टू माइनस 14, एक्स इज द लेंथ ऑफ द वन पार्ट ऑफ द साइड, सो लेंथ कैन नॉट बी नेगेटिव, सो एक्स प्लस 14 नॉट इक्वल टू 0, सो नाउ वी कैंसिल एक्स प्लस 14 बोथ साइड्स, 16 इंटू एक्स प्लस 14 इक्वल्स टू 48 एक्स। नाउ दिस इज 3 एक्स, सो 3 एक्स माइनस एक्स इक्वल्स टू 14, विच इम्प्लाइज 3x माइनस x इक्वल्स टू 14, विच इम्प्लाइज 2x इक्वल्स टू 14, विच इम्प्लाइज x इक्वल्स टू 7। सो देयरफोर AC इक्वल्स टू AB इक्वल्स टू, देयरफोर AB इक्वल्स टू x प्लस 8, सो x इज 7, 7 प्लस 8 equals to 15 centimeter and AC equals to x is 7, 7 plus 6 equals to 13 centimeter. So length of AB equals to 15 centimeter and length of AC equals to 13 centimeter. This is the answer of the problem. Now the second problem. In the figure, this figure, xy and x dash y dash are two parallel tangents. xy and x dash y dash are two parallel tangents to a circle with center O and another tangent AB with point of contact C intersecting xy at the point A and x dash y dash at the point B. Prove that angle AOB equals to 90 degree. So we draw the figure. Now this is the figure xy and x dash y dash are two parallel tangents at the point P and Q. As the two tangents are parallel, so PQ is a diameter. XY and X dash Y dash, two tangents are parallel, so PQ is a diameter. And another tangent whose point of contact C whose intersect the XY at the point A and intersect at the point B. And required to prove angle AOB, prove that angle AOB equals to 90 degree. Now first we join O and C. Now we join O and C. Construction. O or join. Let angle AOC equals to theta. Let this angle be theta. So therefore, AP and AC are two tangents to an external point A. So according to theorem, these two tangents subtend equal angle at the center. So therefore, angle AOP is equals to angle AOC, and angle AOC equals to theta. So angle AOP equals to theta. Also let angle BOC equals to phi. This is theta. Let angle BOC equals to phi. Therefore, BC and BQ are two tangents through the external point B. So they subtend equal angle at the center. So angle BOQ, angle BOQ is also phi. So this is also phi. So therefore, PQ is a diameter as PQ is a diameter. So POQ is a straight angle. So theta plus phi plus phi equals to 180 degree, which implies 2 into theta plus phi equals to 180 degree, which implies theta plus phi equals to 90 degree. Now theta plus phi, so therefore angle AOB equals to AOC plus angle BOC. Now angle AOB equals to AOC plus BOC, and now AOC equals to theta and BOC equals to theta. Sorry, AOC equals to theta and BOC equals to phi. Now theta plus phi is 90 degree. So therefore AOB equals to 90 degree, proved. Next, question number 3. AB is a chord of length 16 cm of a circle of radius 10 cm. The tangents at A and B intersect at P. Find the length of PA. At first, we draw the figure. Now, this is the figure of the question number 3. AP and BP, AB is a chord of length is 16 cm. AP and BP are two tangents. Now we calculate the length of, find the length of AP. What is the length of AP? Now AO, BO and OP are joined, and the OP intersect the chord AB at the point L. Now in triangle AOL and triangle BOL, we have OA equals to OB, both are radii of the same circle, and angle AOP is equals to angle BOP. AOP equals to angle BOP. AOP means angle AOL equals to angle BOL. Because the length of two tangents passing through an external point subtend equal angle at the center. So these two angles are equal. And OL is a common side. So this angle is included angle, and OL is a common side. OL equals to OL. And included angle equals to included angle AOL equals to included angle BOL. So therefore, triangle AOL is congruent with triangle BOL by AS congruency. So therefore, AL equals to BL. AL equals to BL and angle A. So therefore the chord AB is bisected. So therefore chord AB is bisected. At L. So therefore OL is perpendicular to AB according to theorem in chapter 3. The line segment through center, if L is bisected, so OL is perpendicular to AB. So this angle is AL equals to BL and an angle. So OL is perpendicular to AB. So therefore angle BOL equals to 90 degree. So therefore BL equals to bisected, total AB is 8 cm, so BL is total AB is 16 cm, so BL equals to 16 by 2 equals to 8 centimeter. So now OL equals to, now this is the right angle triangle, OL equals to OB square minus BL square. BOL is right angle triangle, right as triangle BLO is right angle. OL square equals to OB square minus BL square, which implies OL equals to OB is 10 square minus BL is 8 square, which implies OL equals to 10 square 100 minus 64, this is 36, square root of 36 is 6. So OL equals to 6 centimeter. So OL is 6 centimeter. Again, now this angle is 90 degree. Radius and tangent are perpendicular. So OBP is right angle triangle. So again, OP square equals to, OP square is equals to, this is the OP. OP square equals to OB square plus BP square, because triangle PBO is right angle, which implies BP square equals to OP square minus OP square minus OB square. Call it number 1. Again, this angle is 90 degree. Again, BLP is also right angle triangle. Again, BP square, this is the hypotenuse, this is equals to BL square minus, sorry, BL square plus LP square, BL square plus LP square, because the triangle BLP is right angle. This is number 2. So comparing 1 and 2, left hand sides are equal. So therefore, OP square minus OP square minus OB square equals to BL square plus LP square. Now OP equals to OL plus LP, and OL is 6. So 6 plus LP whole square minus OB is 10 square. This is equals to BL. BL is 8 square plus LP square. Now this is 6 square is 36 plus 2 6 is 12, LP plus LP square minus 10 square is 100, 64 plus LP square. LP square cancel both side. So this is 12 LP equals to 64, 36 minus 100 minus 64, this is plus 64, which implies LP equals to 64 plus 64, 128 divided by 12. Now cancel, 4 3 is 12, 4 3 is 12, 4 2 is 8, this is 32 by 3, this is the LP. So therefore BP square equals to, BP square, from 2 BP square equals to, BP square equals to BL square plus LP square. Now BL is 8 square plus LP square is 32/3 होल स्क्वायर 64 प्लस 3^2 9 नाउ 32^2 32 इक्वल्स टू 2^5 सो 32^2 इक्वल टू 2^10 ऑलरेडी यू नो 2^10 इक्वल्स टू 1024 1024 सो दिस इज इक्वल्स टू 9 इज एलसीएम 6 कैरी 3 57 प्लस 1024 सो दिस इज इक्वल्स टू 0 0 सो बीपी स्क्वायर इक्वल्स टू 1600/9 सो देयरफॉर बीपी इक्वल्स टू स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ 16 दिस इज 40/3 सो बीपी इक्वल्स टू 40/3 बीपी एंड एपी लेंथ ऑफ टू टेंजेंट्स आर इक्वल बीपी एंड एपी आर टू टेंजेंट्स एंड सो लेंथ ऑफ टू टेंजेंट्स आर इक्वल सो देयरफॉर एपी इक्वल्स टू 40/3 सेंटीमीटर दिस इज आंसर Next, question number 4. Two tangents PQ and PR are drawn from an external point to a circle with center O such that angle RPQ equals to 30 degree. A chord RS is drawn parallel to the tangent PQ. Find the angle RQS. So we first draw the figure. And this is now question number 4. PQ and PR are two tangents and RS is parallel to PQ. These and these are parallel. PQ is parallel to RS and angle RPQ equals to 30 degree given. What is the measurement of the angle RQS? So, find the measurement of the angle RQS. Now, this angle is 30 degree. So, PQ, length of two tangents equal, PQ equals to PR. So, therefore, in the triangle PQR, length of two, measurement of these two angles are equal. This angle is 30 degree. So, therefore, angle PQR, two equal because PQR is an isosceles triangle. So, length of PQ, measurement of angle PQR equals to angle PRQ is equals to 180 degree minus 30 divided by 2. So this is 150 degree divided by 2. This is equals to 75 degree. So therefore this angle is 75 and this angle is 75 degree. So as PQ is parallel to RS, so this angle equals to 75 degree. This angle is equals to 75 degree. So now join OS and OR are joined. OS and OR are joined. So therefore, this angle is 75 and this angle is 75. Now, angle ORP. OR is a radius and RP is a tangent. So, ORP is equals to 90 degree and QRP is 75 degree. So, therefore, angle ORQ, ORQ, only this angle, ORQ is 90 degree minus 75 degree. So, this is equals to 15 degree. ORQ equals to 15 degree. So, therefore, angle ORS, angle ORS, only this angle, whole angle is 75 and this is 15, so 75 minus 15 equals to 60 degree, so this angle equals to 60 degree, in triangle ROS, OR equals to OS, both are radii of the same circle, so therefore, angle OSR equals to angle ORS and ORS equals to 60 degree. So therefore this is equals to 60 degree. So therefore this angle equals to 60 degree. Therefore the remaining angle SOR equals to 180 degree minus sum of other two angles 60 plus 60. So this is 60 degree. 180 minus 120, this is equal to 60 degree. So therefore this angle is 60 degree. And so therefore RQ is equals to half of the angle at center, ROS. Angle at circumference is equals to half of angle at center formed by the same arc RS. So half into angle ROS. So half into 60 degree. So this is 30 degree. So therefore angle RQS equals to 30 degree. This is the answer. Last question. Question number. Last question, question number 5. Two tangents AB and AC are drawn to a circle with center O such that angle BAC equals to 120 degree. Prove that OA equals to twice OB. So first we draw the figure. Now this is the figure of question 5. AB and AC are two tangents. And such that angle measurement of angle BAC equals to 120 degree. So this angle equals to 120 degree. Now prove that OA equals to twice OB. Sorry, OA equals to twice AB. OA equals to twice AB. Now we join OB and OC. So this is the right angle. Radius and tangent perpendicular. And these two triangles are congruent, so therefore this angle equals to this angle. So total angle is 120 degree, so therefore this angle is equals to half of the total angle. So therefore this angle equals to 60 and this angle equals to 60. So again I repeat, triangle AOB and triangle AOC are congruent triangle. So therefore these two angles are corresponding angle, so therefore these two angles are equal. But total angle is 120 degree, so therefore each angles are 120 by 2 equal to 60 degree. Now AOB, now ABO is right angle triangle. Now triangle ABO is right angle. So this angle is 90 degree. So therefore OB by AB, sorry, OB means OA by, now OA by AB. Now according to this right angle triangle, this angle is 60. So according to this angle, OA is the base. OA is the hypotenuse. OA is the always hypotenuse. OA is the hypotenuse and AB by, so right, AB by OA. So right, AB by OA. So AB is base according to this angle and OA is always hypotenuse. So therefore AB by OA, AB is base by hypotenuse is cos 60 degree, cos theta. So AB by OA value of cos 60 is half. So therefore OA equals to twice AB. Okay. Thank you.